oh, that's a reflection of my window. I was like, how am I seeing something that's in front of me? Hey, everybody. It is Tia here. I'm here to talk about episode 27 of Big Brother season 26. I'm so sorry. It's dark. My living room doesn't have the best lighting. It's okay, like, sitting in it because I can see, but I guess on videos it doesn't look so great. So it's very dark. So I'm really sorry about that. Episode 27 is the eviction. It also started off with the end of the veto ceremony, where Mackenzie has to make a decision as to whether or not she's going to use the power veto. So I was really irritated that Angela got saved again. Before she even said this in the diary, I literally wrote down, literally, she's a cockroach. And then she compares herself to a cockroach. And I'm like, well, if the shoe fits, like, ugh, so irritating. But man, I mean, cockroaches are disgusting. So just keep that in mind. Comparing yourself to a cockroach, it's like, is that really the comparison you want to make? However, getting Quinn out potentially is huge. So I was very pleased that Chelsea made the power move and put Quinn up. Mad respect, because I felt like she took the easy way out in her first head of household. So I was, you know, more respect to her. And you know, if she ends up going to the final two, I hope not, because there's other people I'd rather see in the final two. But if she ends up going to the final two, that's going to be something that I remember personally. Honestly, I think it's absolutely horrible how the house guests were trying to get Leah to kiss Quinn. I was really disgusted by this, because you can't tell me, I mean, they know that they're friends, I'm sure, because they're not stupid. Like, they're very observant, right? Like, nobody, how, at this point in the game, everybody's pretty observant. So you can't tell me that they don't know she's not attracted to him. Like, do they seriously not see the way that she looks when he's, like, around and too, like, over the top and touching her? I don't know how they couldn't see that. Like, I see just little clips of them together, and I can see it. My sister and I have talked about it. We can see it. We're just like, she looks so uncomfortable and awkward. Like, she doesn't want to be there when he's doing this stuff. So you can't tell me that these house guests are not aware of this, or are they just ignoring it? I don't know. Like, and then they're putting her on the spot and peer pressuring her to kiss him. Like, no, that's not okay. That's not okay at all. I think they know too, that they have to know, because when they were playing marry, kiss, evict, and she said she would marry him, and then he's, like, all going over, like, oh, it only took 42 days, blah, 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 blah. So they have to know that there is not a mutual attraction there. It is completely one-sided. I also don't like the way that he brought it up hours later. What are you doing? Hi, sweetheart, please go back. Can you go?
Go?
Yeah. Can I finish this, please?
Nope, you can't.
Toddlers, everybody. You can't, or I didn't like the way that he brought it up hours later to continue to try to get a kiss out of her. And then wouldn't leave it alone when she said no. And then he's like, can we hold hands? A no is a no, man. Like, take a hint. She said no. And then she said in the diary room that she thinks she has a crush on him. I could be 100% wrong, and maybe I'm wrong, but I don't feel like this is true. I feel like she's been stuck in the house for so long that she's sort of starting to believe her pretend affection. Like, I just feel like up before that, now she was, maybe she did kind of care about him as a friend a little bit, but I felt like a lot of it, especially lately, was her 100% take. I mean, she's even admitted this, so this isn't out there. Taking advantage of his affection and his attraction to her. And I feel like she's starting to believe that, but I really don't think that Leah is actually attracted to Quinn. And this is because, and I've been in this situation where people have been really uncomfortable and over the top and can't just take no for an answer. So I've been in that position many times, and not once in that position has my, like, uncomfortability, I don't think that's really a word, but I use it as a word. Maybe it is a word. ever turned into attraction. Ever. I really don't think she's genuinely attracted to him. I think she's just kind of starting to believe the lies. And I think she'll realize that once she's out of the house. So I think that's, you know, actually genuinely it's good that he's gone, because I think she needs that separation from him, honestly. Yeah, but I don't like the way he was continuing to pressure her. And it's like, girl, are you really okay with that? Like, I don't think she's okay with that at all. So I'm really glad she said no and then left when they were pressuring her to kiss him, because that was not okay at all. I was like half a page of me talking about that. Literally, I was just so angry about that. I can't believe that Mackenzie and Chelsea were dumb enough to even consider keeping Quinn. Like, no, he's not being genuine. He's not being genuine. He's not telling you the truth. He's not being honest with you. He will say whatever he thinks that you need to hear to get your vote for him to stay. Quinn does not speak an ounce of truth to anybody, except in the diary room. That's the only place I feel like he's ever honest. Quinn will say whatever he needs to say to stay. So I'm so glad that... Oh, did she vote for him? No, I don't think she did. I'm pretty sure Mackenzie did not vote for him. So I'm so glad she did not buy that, and she did not vote for him to stay. But I was just like... Are you kidding me? To even think for a second that he would be loyal to you. No, this is Quinn. He's a rat. He doesn't know how to be honest. His whole game has been lies from the beginning. You know this. And you're going to actually consider keeping him? Are you nutso? So yes, I'm very glad that Mackenzie voted for Quinn to leave. I'm very glad that Cam voted for Quinn to leave, because I know he was kind of on the fence too. I was just so happy that he got the votes and he's gone. Goodbye, Quinn. Good riddance. Goodbye. You don't deserve to win this game. You are a rat, a smelly, stinky, lying rat, and I'm glad you're gone. You're a terrible player. You think you're a super fan, but you can't even play this game correctly. Do you seriously, like, for being a super fan, don't you realize that people who lie and lie and lie the way you do and get caught over and over and over again don't win, because you make people mad and eventually they realize they can't keep you, that you're too much of a liability and a threat to their games? Sir, would it have killed you to speak the truth to somebody besides some girl that you're forcing your affections on? Goodbye, Quinn. Good riddance. I cannot believe I ever thought that I wanted you to win. My good kitty's like, you're stressing out. Calm down. Thank you, sweet pea. Anyway, now that Quinn is gone, let's get Angela out of the house, and then maybe we can get back to a, like, semi-normal game. Because although I don't, outside of Angela, I don't really like everybody, even Leah. Leah finally did something. I didn't like Leah, but she finally did something. I'd be okay with any of them making it to the final two. I really, really, really want T-Core and Chemo to make it to the final two. But I would be okay with anybody. So, stop. Stop, sweet pea. I bet Zingba is coming, and I'm very excited. Zingba Jr. is coming, it sounds like, and I'm very excited to see what Zingba Jr. has to say. So I better go because I'm getting interrupted. Thank you so much for watching. When I come back from my bereavement leave, I will be back to normal, getting caught up, and I'm very excited to see how the rest of this game goes.